I made the case that we all are hoping that at the end of the inquiry, the select committee will be able to offer findings, recommendations that can assist the department and the government and the country to avoid any repetition of the mistakes slash wrongdoing that occurred. And so from that point of view, none of us can doubt the validity and the efficacy of the inquiry. But it can't be open-ended. It is not something that can last forever. And you will forgive me if I have gotten the impression that there are certain members of that committee that have reached a point where they're asking questions simply for the sake of asking questions, and in order to prolong the inquiry to an extent that I insist is unreasonable if there is a specific objective to get at what went wrong and to offer suggestions as to how we might ensure that it not happen in the future. I closed by saying to them, listen, if the committee will concede that it can't be a blank check, that it can't be open-ended, that government cannot simply fall in with request after request for extra budgetary, because that's what it is, allocation of resources. And if the committee were prepared to offer to government a clear timeline, if the committee were prepared to say, look, we expect to conclude by December or January, something that's reasonable, and on that basis, to submit proposals for expenditure that would cover that remaining period in a reasonable fashion, government would reconsider its position and not then insist on a cutoff after November.